Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte says that face shields should only be worn inside hospitals. Senate President Vicente Sotto III says that the chief executive made that statement during a meeting with lawmakers in Malacañang last night. He also noted that those who attended that indoor meeting were not required to wear face shields. Just yesterday, however, the health department said that face shields may be only removed when outdoors. This comes as Sotto and Manila Mayor Isko Moreno are among the politicians urging the national government to scrap the face shield mandate, saying that the Philippines is the only country in the world that requires them. But Health Secretary Francisco Duque says that the policy is essential and backed by science. The National Task Force on COVID-19 Response will meet later on to discuss this matter.
Pag-uusapan naman, ATF kami mamaya. Pag-uusapan namin yan. If there's any announcements sa bagong protocol, ilalabas po namin.
The Philippines' COVID-19 death toll tops 23,000. That's after the health department recorded 158 new deaths Wednesday. Over 5,000 new cases have been reported, bringing the total number of infections nationwide to 1,332,000. The number of active cases decreased to 56,000 after over 7,000 patients recovered. So far, the region with the highest positivity rate is Region 4B, followed by Region 12 and 2. Health Undersecretary and COVID-19 Treatment Chief Leopoldo Vega says that they're now working to expand the one-command COVID-19 hospital referral system beyond Metro Manila, as some provinces face a shortage in hospital beds.
Daan namin itong nire-regionalize, ano? Kasi alam namin na marami din kaming calls na coming outside of Metro Manila. So ang inuna namin ginawa, yung one regional hospital command na sa Region 4A at saka sa Region 3. At gumawa na rin kami ng regional one hospital command, lalong-lalo na sa Mindanao, sa Southern Mindanao at saka sa Caraga area.
A new batch of China Sinovac vaccines arrived in the Philippines today, Thursday. This latest shipment carrying 1.5 million doses landed at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport at past 7 this morning. The vaccines will be placed in storage as the health department awaits a certificate of analysis from its manufacturer before being distributed to local government units. On Wednesday, the DOH began distributing the 1 million Sinovac shots that arrived last week, after receiving the certificate of analysis for that batch. One of President Duterte's advisors says that the vaccines procured by the private sector will be arriving in the coming months as more members of the A4 priority group want to get vaccinated. The details from Alvin El Chico.
While security guard Michael Tabon is excited to take the Sinovac vaccine ordered by his company, his fellow worker Mary Ann Agabao remains hesitant on taking the jab against COVID-19.
Para lang po sa ano sir, protection, para lang po sa sarili, pamilya. Kasi po araw-araw po akong bumibiyahe. Marami pong makasalamuhang tao.
Ayoko po kasi, natatakot po ako eh. Sa ngayon po, siguro makakapag-antay naman po. Pag napatunayan na pong effective at mabisa po yung vaccine, so saka po ako magpapabakuna.
The first ever private sector purchased vaccine will arrive Thursday morning in Manila. Filipino-Chinese businessmen paid more than 300 million pesos for the 500,000 doses of Sinovac vaccines. Speaking on behalf of the group, Ambassador Francis Chua says the Filipino-Chinese Federation is willing to order more if there is a need.
We are open. Sino pa man may gusto, we are welcome to come to the Federation anytime. Just register and say that they are willing to pay for the employee.
Meanwhile, San Miguel Corporation has started vaccinating its workers using vaccines provided by the national government. 500 workers were inoculated Wednesday in La Salle Gym as part of government's vaccination program. Though the company targets to inoculate its 70,000-strong workforce, San Miguel has been deploying medical staff to help out at vaccination sites in various cities.
Itong COVID, Walang pinipili ito. Kanya lahat tayo kailangan magpabaksin. Kahit ano pong vaccine, i-take natin, huwag na ho tayo mamili. At pag nagbaksin ho tayo, sigurado safe ang ating pamilya.
Another group of businessmen is awaiting the arrival of AstraZeneca vaccines by mid-August. Over 1 million doses are expected by July 14, of which more than 400,000 doses will be shared with several local government units. The quantity will be given back to the private sector once the LGU vaccine purchase arrives.
Rather than just keep all the doses in the storage, we are allowing them to use it already. We discussed it and I said that let's help the second batch and the LGU on the prorate of their order. Para pwede rin sila start, they can start already as early as July.
Concepcion confirms another group of businessmen will get their Moderna vaccine order this month, followed by the second batch of AstraZeneca in August or September. Meanwhile, private orders of Novavax and Covaxin, according to Concepcion, face delays due to the export ban in India. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.